Yo, what's up, guys? My name is Cody, and today we're going to be doing a Chargers mock draft. Now, my Chargers, we really need a lot of things. We need a whole new O-line, D-line. We just need a whole new front seven, and we need a free safety with Jalil Adai gone. So now, we don't know who's going to take over that role. But, so let's get this started. First round, I have them picking Dexter Lawrence. This could have gone either way. I had them picking either Christian Wilkins, Draymond Jones, Dexter Lawrence as pretty much their go-to people. And I also had them picking Andre Dillard from Washington State. But I went with Dexter Lawrence because he's a big body guy. He'll definitely help us out on the run. And for a big man, he can definitely rush the passer. And by the way, I forgot to mention he's from Clemson. So, yeah. Round two, I have them picking Bobby Evans, our old tackle, the old tackle from Oklahoma. He'll definitely help us out in the pass rush, and I mean the passing game and in the run game. He's another big body guy that we could definitely use on our O-line because our O-line is definitely getting trashed around and stuff like that. So that's why I feel like Bobby Evans will be a great addition for the right side to take over for Sam Tevy. Round three, I have them picking Jelani Tavai from Hawaii. Before the Thomas Davis signing, I have them picking Jelani Tavai to kind of like take over, to pretty much learn behind Kaiser White, even though he's a rookie. But Jelani Tavai, I can tell you that his weakness right now, his only weakness is that he doesn't have that good closing speed, sideline to sideline speed. No, he has really good sideline speed, I'm sorry. But he doesn't have that that good lateral speed. But he's really good in the run, and he's really good at coverage. And that is definitely the type of person that we need, because the team really has struggled to stop the run. And what really made it worse is when we saw the Patriots game. So, yeah. And everybody knows how that went. So, round four, I have them picking Ross Pierce-Barker from Alabama. We definitely need O-line help, and he'll definitely help us out. He could play Dan Feeney's spot, he could play Mike Pouncey or Forrest Lamp's spot. The reason why I have them picking Ross is because Dan Feeney, he wasn't playing too well in his sophomore year. He's played well in his freshman year, but not his sophomore year. So I have them picking him and pretty much have him groom around the veterans there. So that way, once the vets leave, he could pretty much play for whoever. Sorry. Round five, I have them picking Isaiah Prince out of Ohio State. He's a really good guy. I saw only a little bit of film of him, because I was honestly paying attention more to Lester Cotton. But I have them picking Isaiah Prince. He's pretty good in the passing game. He's really good in the run game. So I feel like he'll help protect both. Because with the new pass rushers, with the pass rushers that are coming, that is happening now, I feel like he'll definitely help us out with that. Round six, I have them picking JoJo McIntosh from Washington. He's a pretty good safety. Byron Murphy and that other safety that's also from Washington that is also projected to be a round one guy. I don't remember his name, but they're pretty much the spotlight, the highlight players that I think. But JoJo McIntosh is one of those players that is going under the radar, who is an underrated player, I feel like, because I've seen some film of him, and I gotta say, it's pretty good. I haven't seen a whole lot of film of these players, by the way, so I'm sorry if I don't sound well-knowledge and stuff like that. I have them picking JoJo McIntosh. I feel like he's a really good player, pretty good instincts. He has that closing speed. He's really good. He's pretty good in the run game, so he'll definitely help us. He's good at coverages, And for our last pick in the seventh round, I have them picking Jonathan Ledbetter from Georgia. He's pretty much going to be Melvin Ingram's replacement DN once he leaves, because he turns 30 this year, if I'm correct. So that's why, like, we need to find a replacement for him ASAP, or else, you know, because of how good of a pass rushers, how good of a defense, I'm sorry, how good of a defensive draft this is. So I have them picking Jonathan Ledbetter as pretty much Melvin Ingram's replacement. Melvin Ingram, he can help groom Jonathan Ledbetter, or Joey Bosa can help him too. So let me know what you guys think about this draft. I went into this. This is my first mock draft video, by the way, guys. So that's why, you know, I'm not too knowledgeable about most of the things that I'm talking about. But this is my first mock draft video, and it'll only get better from here on out. So let me know what you guys think about the picks. I'm going to be doing a lot of these mock draft videos all the way that leads up to the draft day, to draft day. So I'm gonna be uploading these from Friday to Sunday, pretty much. Well, I'm going to try to upload them from Friday to Sunday. And I'll get them out to you guys as fast, as easy, as good as they can possibly get. I will definitely be watching a little bit more film of them. But other than that, I mean, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you guys think about the picks. Comment them down below in the video. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed. And I'll see y'all later. Peace.